Large language models, or LLMs, are amazing. You can ask almost anything and get the answer. For example, who won the Super Bowl in 2024?
As of my last update in January 2022, I cannot provide the result of the Super Bowl in 2024 since it would occur after my last update.
Yikes. This illustrates one problem with LLMs. They can go stale since they're only updated every so often. It's not the only problem, though. LLMs also suffer from hallucinations, or false information presented as true. These happen because LLMs work by learning the probability distributions of words in their source material and then sampling from those distributions. For example, the LLM is much more likely to see the pattern "the sky is blue" than "the sky is hungry," so it's more likely to answer the question "what color is the sky?" with blue. There's also the attribution problem. It's not possible to know the how or why of an LLM's response. And as any business with data or proprietary information knows, customization just isn't possible with these so-called out-of-the-box models. Retrieval-Augmented Generation, or RAG, is a method that integrates the database technologies developed over the past few decades with modern AI solutions to address these concerns. The generation, or G in RAG, generates text based on a prompt, just like an LLM. This generation is then augmented with the ability to retrieve data, either from the internet, proprietary business information, or some other selected source. Under the hood, RAG essentially works by modifying the prompt to the LLM based on the additional data. Roughly, the original prompt to the LLM, "who won the Super Bowl in 2024, might become, "who won the Super Bowl this year, given these news articles discussing the Super Bowl winner?" So, RAG is like an LLM taking an open book exam. You study and study for hours, just like the LLM trains for a long time. But during the exam, you also get to look up information in a book. How does this solve the problems that LLMs suffer from? Well, if the data augmenting the LLM is recent, that addresses the staleness problem. Further, a recent study showed RAG reduced hallucinations by over 60% on two benchmark tasks. The attribution problem is also addressed, since you are given external sources that can help to verify model output. And finally, the ability to provide your own data without needing to retrain the model solves the customization problem. So RAG is a very helpful tool, but it's not without its own challenges. Lots of data means it can be difficult to retrieve information quickly, and RAG doesn't necessarily guarantee a higher accuracy. The research is ongoing. But RAG has been around since at least 2001, and interest in it is reviving because of the recent explosion of LLMs. In fact, we're already seeing some key problems with LLMs being addressed by RAG. So the next time someone asks you what RAG is or why it's important, be sure to retrieve some knowledge from this video to augment your response.